And there's a lot of evidence that the retailers are advance ordering way in advance to preempt these supply chain locations over the festive season. Does that suggest that the goods are going to get to market, are going to get to the shelves, we won't see shortages? And what does that imply for the next big peak, which is Lunar New Year for China?
Yeah, I think that is largely the case. There has been a significant level of pre-ordering, and actually the container index did fall somewhat during the first half of this month from its absolute peaks. Meanwhile, you have to bear in mind that there is a large order book of new ships on order, so these will start joining the fleet over the next 24 to 36 months. And that again will add capacity. So I think all in all, yes, the worst is over, you could say, and into the new year, I'm confident that there may still be swings, but overall, I think the worst is over. Yes.
Esben Martin here, downstream, which is your space. I'm curious to know what constraints have eased, and also how and why, because going into this pandemic, shortage of ships, you can't build them overnight. Shortage of containers, maybe you can. And a lot of people have been sort of last resort. They've sort of sourced their own stevedores, longshoremen, etc. I don't know. If you give in and pay them more, maybe the labor crunch will ease. But in your view, what's changed for the better and why?
No, I mean this problem isn't just, the ships. It's also, as you say, the ports and the logistics chain beyond the ports. The shortage of lorry or truck drivers, trains, individual workers who simply couldn't get to work due to the pandemic has exacerbated this problem. So it's really right through the chain, and as you say, containers being in the wrong place at the wrong time has added to it. As I say, the demand levels simply caught everybody off guard, and then exacerbated by also big issues for us, like crew change, failure of governments to designate seafarers as key workers, as they actually are obliged to do, but in many countries have failed to do. Far too slow vaccination for seafarers and other transport workers. All these problems, including at the port level, ports not working 24/7, which of course they are now in the case of LA and Long Beach, particularly. All of these problems have added up to the situation that we have been facing.